What is up? It is President Q of 2K Central hitting you guys with five things you need to know before NBA 2K19 releases. And everybody knows the release day is pretty soon, and I don't want you guys to get screwed on your first day when you pick it up. But before we get into it, I would really appreciate if you guys hit that like button. Can we get this video to 10 likes? Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you can, because you already know 2K Central is your best place for anything and everything in 2K. Now, let's go ahead and get to it. Number one, the Pro-Am and the Jordan Rec Center will be on Hall of Fame difficulty sliders. Now, you may be asking, what the heck does that even mean, and how do I prepare for that? Well, first off, you want to prepare for it by playing a Hall of Fame in your My Career. And it's a good thing, because you're not just going to be playing a Hall of Fame for no reason this year, homie. You actually get way more money and way more experience on your badges this year if you play in Hall of Fame. Also, you'll get used to the sliders, so you know what shots you can and cannot take when you do go online and want to play competitively. The huge issue for me is that I never really played on Hall of Fame because it just felt like pure unadulterated cheese. But if I really want to be a great player, then I know I got to play on those sliders so I can understand just what I'm going up against when I actually step online. Number two, this is a really quick and easy one. Defense will be better this year. Plain and simple, all across the board. You won't be able to left right cheese. The step back cheese is gone. And also, blow bys are not going to be as easy to accomplish, so you're definitely gonna have to learn how to run things like the pick and roll, how to move the ball, how to actually use dribble moves, post moves, and other things like it, because homie, people will lock you up if you don't got a bag of tricks or two up your sleeve. Next up, for number three, before the 94 overall point, takeover applies to your primary attributes only, and it's plus 10 to your primary attributes. So if you're a playmaker, shot creator, or even a slasher, you get plus 10 ball handling. So that means if you have, let's say, a 76 ball handling and you go into takeover, well, you actually are capable of speed boosting, if that really matters that much to you. And it also applies with shooters, you get a plus 10. So if you have an 83 three-pointer in mid-range, you might want to start letting that thing fly when you get into takeover, because you have over a 90 overall shot. And also, your badges will get a boost, so if you have limitless range, you can best believe you pretty much knocked it up a whole nother tier. So if you got gold, you probably got all the fame when you're in takeover. Number four, now this is just recently confirmed, that you might have felt it in the prelude. Badge progression and experience progression as a whole is a lot quicker this year. They said from 92 and below, it's going to be the quickest amount of upgrades you've ever gotten before in your career of 2K. I love it. I really do. So that means we'll be able to get the superstar status a little bit easier this year. But from 93 to 99, supposedly the grind is atrocious. It's nasty. It's stinking. But you know, I dig it. You know, I'm a grind head, so I don't mind stepping into the trenches and grinding my way to 95. Because at 95, you unlock some kind of rebirth ability where they give you a brand new guy at 90 overall. And he starts off with all five of his core badges maxed out. Now that's what I'm talking about. And last but not least, this is kind of a plug, but not really. I will be streaming on Mixer on Thursday night. President Q, no spaces. I want to be able to help you guys out and hop online and actually look up some of the builds that you guys are making, so you guys don't screw over your builds. I'll be giving you guys suggestions, of course, on what you can do to make your build better, or, you know, change it up to fit your playstyle. And I'll just be online for about an hour or two just helping guys compare builds. So you definitely want to stay tuned for that. And my brother will be here on YouTube, of course. I don't know if he's gonna be streaming Thursday. You'll have to follow our Twitter and see about that. And there's also one other really huge thing. I'm bringing a new series to the channel called Coaching. Basically, if you guys know how to record up to 10 minutes of footage, record a whole part game, record a whole half of your Jordan Rec Center game, and just please don't send me your best game, but send me a good game, link me in it, either post it to YouTube and email it to me, link me on Twitter, anything, and I will make a video reviewing your gameplay and also help you guys out on what you can do a little bit better, of course. I still haven't come up with a name for this series, but I definitely will be coaching you guys on how to be a better player so you can one day become that NBA 2K League prospect sooner rather than later. But yeah, this has been it. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to hit that like, subscribe, and share button if you guys enjoyed this, because you already know 2K Central is your best place for anything and everything 2K, but that's a given. I will talk to you guys later. This has been your President Q, and I am out of here. Peace.